I think I'm gonna make this one very brief because we've had this shtick through the entire tour where I turn around and see the figure on the bus and realise I made a terrible mistake. Well, yes, I made a terrible mistake because I said that we'd save 350 billion in public money and actually it's going to cost the economy more than 2 billion. 2 billion.
Get your numbers right,
Boris! Come on,
Boris. No, how well slip prepared slip of the tongue, you. Slip of the old tongue.
Two billion.
It will cost the economy a week. Even in the middle of the road Brexit. Who wants to be in the middle of the road? Let's face it. Jeremy Corbyn isn't necessarily offering any best solutions in order to compete with my party's completely unachievable Brexit plan. He has offered the slightly less unachievable Brexit plan. But what we need is a solution rather than unachievable plans. So yes, as Tim suggested, we should really have a referendum on the facts, the first ever. But until then, you'll have to settle for an apology from me.
I've been shortlisted for Young European of the Year, and I think this is a fantastic opportunity, actually, for Britain to say that the young people of Britain do not want Brexit. This is not a future that we want, this is a future that's being forced upon us.
Yeah.
And it's time that all of those young people came out and spoke for what they believe in very passionately. And what I want to say is that if we want to win a first referendum on the facts, then we need to reinvigorate that passion for Europe. We need to celebrate our European identities, and yep. We need to instill hope in people that remaining in the EU will bring them opportunities and benefits. Keep up your fighting spirit. Okay, this song's called If You Only Had a Heart. It's not aimed at anyone in particular. Of God.
It's nearly time for us to go, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for coming to see us.